Hey guys, what's going on? It's in the gym with Team MassiveJoes, Lifestyle, here at Adelaide's mecca of bodybuilding, Powerhouse Fitness Gym, with my brother Big Swole.
What's up, people?
We're about to train some biceps. Let's get it on. All right, so this bicep workout, we're gonna do a major positions of flexion focus. So we're gonna focus on the mid-range position of flexion, the stretch position of flexion, the contracted position of flexion, and we're gonna hit some brachialis as well. So main focus for every bicep workout is positions of flexion. Starting with exercise number one, gonna hit that mid-range position of flexion with standing alternating dumbbell curl. You guys know, man, every workout we go on ham. Means we've got to spend a little bit of time warming up first, so we don't go straight into it. So nice and light, warm up, work up to the working weight, make sure the form is on point, and then we get busy.
Weak, I'm drinking lean. It helped me sleep. Illuminati, I'm from the streets. Never saw my body. We taking bodies. Put in work. Put in work. Put in work. Put them in that dirt. Shout out that motherland. 12 years old with guns in hand. They don't ask no questions, nigga. All they do is bang, bang, bang. They don't ask no questions. All they do is bang.
So to make sure we're nice and warm, we just start real light, man. Right down the bottom of the rack, and then just slowly increase. So slowly run up the rack until we hit our working weight, and then we'll start with our first working set from there.
You got a problem with it, then that's your problem. I fuck with Asian niggas, and I fuck with Migos. I fuck with Haitian niggas, all they speak is Creole. I said, all I speak is real.
All right, so for this first exercise of standing alternating dumbbell curl, we're going Team MassiveJoes extended hypertrophy, which means we're going 5 working sets. First one's gonna be 15 or more reps. Then we're gonna increase the weight. We're gonna go for around 12 reps. Then we're gonna increase again, go for around 10. Increase again, go for around 8 to 10 with a rest pause, and then the fifth and final working set, increase again and hit that double drop set. Let's work.
Yeah. Check it out. See, the only thing you need to do right here is just nod your fucking head. Yeah. Yeah. Break your fucking neck, bitches.
Standing alternating dumbbell bicep curls, man. In fact, any type of bicep curl, the most important thing that you want to keep in mind with your technique is to keep tension in the biceps. One thing that a lot of people do wrong is they bring in a lot of different muscle groups that they're not necessarily trying to target. They'll bring in front delts, they'll bring in chest, they'll bring in back, they'll bring in all parts of the shoulder, everything except for the bicep. So the one thing you want to really focus on when you're doing any curling movement is mind-muscle connection with that bicep. Make the bicep do the work. Make the bicep lift the weight. Make the bicep put the weight back down.
Another important thing when you're doing biceps, man, and a lot of people do, is they pick a weight that's too heavy. You've got to remember the bicep as a muscle itself isn't really that big. So you want to make sure you're focusing on lifting the weight properly and not swinging that shit. You're going to get more results doing a few more reps with a lighter weight than actually going stupid, swinging some weight around and thinking, you know, you're getting a bit of a pump out of it, when really all you do is throwing around some front raises. You really got to focus on that that technique, which is why bicep training, I think, is so mentally challenging. Come on, baby, come on. Because you really have to focus on getting that technique right.
Oh, we're getting our pump on today, man. We're getting our pump on today. Yeah, baby. I want you guys to pay particular attention to Swole's elbow position, man. Have a look at that elbow position. You notice that elbow position does not move in a vertical plane throughout the entire movement. By doing that, he's making sure that he's keeping tension on the bicep and keeping tension out of the delts, out of the front delt in particular. So always, what I like to do is I like to think that there's a pole running from the ceiling to the floor, and it runs through your elbow. So your elbow can't move forward, it can't move backwards, it can't move side to side. It's fixed in position, fixed in space. That's just gonna make sure that you're getting the most out of this movement for your biceps.
So now
be shutting it down. The way we put it on, coming through like a steamroller. Me and Dre, nigga, ain't no
fucking around. You guys can see with this particular movement as well, what we're doing when we curl is we're doing what we call supinating our wrists. So as we curl up, we're twisting our wrists so that our palms are facing the ceiling. What that's going to do is it's just going to make that little bit of difference to this movement and really get the contraction in the bicep. You can see if you just stand there with your arm in a curled position and you have your palm facing your other palm and you just twist it up, you can see straight away that your bicep contracts just that little bit
more. It shortens, man.
So that's why when we're hitting these particular movement, we're curling up, we're supinating the wrist, we're making sure our palms are facing the ceiling, and we're really squeezing to make the most of this movement.
Yep.
Ooh. One thing, you know, Joe was talking about what you want to focus on, and one thing personally I focus on when I'm doing biceps is you follow the path of, and you focus on the concentric phase and the eccentric phase. So on that way down, you got to make sure you put as much effort into the way down as you do on the way up. So as you can see here, Joe's following that path, he's bringing around in a nice semicircle. So that's really important because it's going to keep that tension right on that bicep. A lot of people, you'll see they just drop the weight straight back down to that starting position. That's not what you want to do. You want to make sure you've got that muscle working for the most amount of time you possibly can in a set. Let's go, baby. Come on now.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Woo. It is something with biceps in particular that a lot of people don't pay enough attention to is the eccentric phase or the negative phase of each rep, that lowering of the weight. Everyone really focuses on the lifting of the weight, but with biceps, as with any other muscle, you're much stronger on the eccentric phase than you are on the concentric. So even when you start to fail lifting the weight, you can still control it on the way down. I like to think of it as unfolding the muscle, so unfolding the bicep. So curl it up, and then on the way down, let the bicep unfold. Curl it up, on the way down, let it unfold. That's the way. Chase them reps, man. Yeah, baby. Come on. Yes. Come on.
Get money, get cash, that check for me. All my niggas just bust your check for me. Everybody from every hood, bang your head till you break your motherfucking neck for me.
Just let me give you real street shit to rock your shit with. We drive your seat, we want this heat, keep bouncing up.
Bang niggas in the head and we do it to death. Reach for them back, wood in the fire, boy. You know we're making an ounce. I know you love the way we be giving you the music, making you bounce. I fuck it up just a little for my niggas. Every time we come through, niggas know that we did it for y'all. And the way we do it for the people, niggas know that we always give it to y'all. I said bounce. In the daytime or the night, when you creep on the low, we just bang this shit up in the truck while you break your nigga. Motherfuckers try to fake my flow. See the way we come right through, when we come right through. We be always blowing the spot again and again and make a nigga really wanna stop. Better tell your crew, your peeps, so my niggas better put their troops on and gather up your soldier niggas. You know you better keep your boots on. Put my niggas in the place. Ayo, wave your hands high now. And the way we put it down, make a nigga wonder what he really gonna try now. What you really wanna do? Just place your bet and put your money where your mouth is. Put my niggas in the street, just break your neck and keep on bouncing.
Watch this form here, man. Watch this form. Completely fatigued, going past failure. The form does not change. It stays on point the entire time. Look at that. Look at that elbow position. Look at the contraction through the bicep. Does not move at all. That's the way you maximize this style of training, man. Keep that form on point. Come on, one more for me. Come on, get it. Yep. Yep. Nice. Good work, man. Woo.
Oh, that's a set right there.
I like it.
We got one more, yeah?
Yeah, we got one more. We got up again too.
So, when Joe's been talking about, you know, positions of flexion here, the most tension that we've got on the bicep in this particular exercise is when your elbow's at about 90 degrees, right there. So what we want to make sure we're doing through that movement is you get started through the bottom and you really accelerate the power. You focus on your biceps to really pull it through to the top. So when that dumbbell's right there, that's where you've got the most tension on your biceps. So you really want to, I guess, push through that hole. You know, that's the hardest part of the whole rep is right there. So you want to make sure you're pushing all the way through it. You got to keep pulling until you're going all the way up. Once you get past that mid-range, the rep becomes a little bit easier. So.
Get money, get cash, that check for me. All my niggas just bust your check for me. Everybody from every hood, bang your head till you break your motherfucking neck for me.
getting that squeeze at the top. Really force the longest contraction in here possible. So what we're trying to do is just completely exhaust this muscle. Because the weight's a little bit lighter, you should be able to squeeze it and squeeze it and squeeze it. Oh, and he's going back for more. So 10 kilos, once again, dropping by about 30%. What you don't want to be doing with your drop sets, man, is actually dropping the weight by too much. If you can get more than, say, 4 or 5 reps on a drop set, you know, the weights, you've dropped it too low. Good squeeze there, man. Good squeeze, good control. As you can see, Joe's focusing on his biceps as much as possible. You know, you're keeping your shoulders out, you're keeping your chest out, your shoulders and your elbows are aligned. You've got all that tension in those biceps. You got this one by yourself, man. Up, up, come on now. Come on.
One more.
Let's go, come on. Get it up, there we go. Same thing, you got this one by yourself. Come on, I'm gonna help you.
There we
go. Fuck, nice set.
Last working set, 5th and final. Let's go, let's work. Come on. Power, yeah, man. Nice. Power, nice. Come on, rip it. Yep. Come on, rip it. Yep. Get it. Get it. Whoosh. Get it. Come on, come up, come up. Easy. Let's go, let's work now. Come on, let's work, let's work. Yep, let's work. Come on. Up, 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 up. One more in there, one more in there. Come on, get it. Push, push, push. Yes. Push. Yes. Nice work, man. The one thing you guys gotta understand, man, whenever you're using intensifying techniques, if it's rest pause, if it's drop set, if it's double drop set, anything that takes you past failure, you have to go to failure before you use that intensifying technique.
Yeah.
You see Swole right here, man, double drop set. Every single time he drops, he's going to absolute failure before dropping the weight. That's the only way to make the most of each intensifying technique. Nice. Keep curling, keep curling. That's the way, come on, get it. Up, 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 nice. Come on, squeeze through. Nice. Come on, squeeze through. Whoosh. Up, 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 up. Get it. And come on, get this, get this. Nice, and again, come on, one more in there. Up, 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 and one more in there. Yes. Woo. Come on, finish. Let's go. Come on, squeeze it now. It's warm-up weight now. Squeeze it and uncurl. That's the way. Squeeze it and unfold the bicep. That's the way. Squeeze it. Perfect reps, man. Perfect reps. Look at that form. That form is clean. Yeah, baby. Up. Yep. Come on, finish. Everything you got. Last couple of reps now, everything you got. Up, 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 up. Yep. Get it. And again, and again. Up. Yes. And again. One more in there. Easy. Easy, one more. Up. Yes. And up. That's the way, man.
Woo!
That is the way.
Damn.
All right, so on to exercise number 2. So we just hit the mid-range position of flexion. Now we're gonna go and we're gonna focus on the stretch position of flexion. So the only way to hit the stretch position of flexion when you're doing bicep is to do a bicep curl where your elbows are behind your torso. And the only way to get your elbows behind your torso is to bicep curl on an incline. So that's what we're gonna do, incline dumbbell bicep curls.
So as you can see here, man, what we're doing is we're doing 5-a-side. So rather than just doing, you know, your 10 reps, or 10 reps together, or alternating, what this allows you to do is really focus on one arm at a time. So focus all your energy on that one arm, make sure your technique's right. So Joe's gonna do 5 reps on one side, 5 reps on the other, then come back to the original side, do another 5 reps, and then 5 reps on the last side. So 10 reps total, but you're spacing them out. You're giving that other arm a little bit of a rest while keeping it in tension. This is actually a really tough exercise to get I guess some heavy weights, but it does allow you to really focus on that mind-muscle connection that you want to get.
The other quite unique aspect of doing five-a-side is the arm that's not working is actually being held in constant tension, but in the stretch position. So this being a stretch position, a flexion exercise where we're really focusing on getting the bicep to exert maximum force in that stretch position, by actually allowing the resting arm to be held in constant tension in that stretch position, really emphasizes that aspect of this exercise. So that's why we love doing five-a-side.
So as you can see here, Joe's elbow should be pretty much all the way back. If we look, the same thing as you said before, if we're running a rod from the ceiling down to the floor, that should be going through the middle of your shoulder and the middle of your elbow. So you want to make sure that elbow's staying back. The more you swing that forward, the more you're bringing your front delts into it, which is not what we want to do. And the other thing too, while this arm here is resting, while we've got it on camera, that dumbbell should be horizontal. You shouldn't be turning it into that supinated grip with it facing, you know, front to back. You want to make sure you're keeping that bicep in tension the whole time. Joe, you can let me know when you're done warming up, man, and we'll get into some serious weight.
So this is the type of exercise where your form is of utmost importance. You cannot sacrifice form for weight in this exercise. So what we like to do in terms of set pattern is we'll start off really light. So we start off with 5 kilos and we'll just run up the rack. So we'll keep doing five-a-side, increase the weight, five-a-side, increase the weight, five-a-side, until we get to a weight where we can't hit five-a-side, and then we'll get each other, our training partners, and we'll force out those reps until we get five-a-side.
Money right, cause I got mine. When I'm around, quit playing, nigga, you can't shine. Woo! You gon' be that next chump, then up in the trunk after being hit by the pump. Is that what you want? Be easy, nigga. I lay your ass out. Believe me, nigga. That's what I'm about. Gangster. You can find a nigga sitting on throne. Hit the clutch, hit the gear, hit the gas, and I'm gone. Yeah. If I can't do it, homie, it can't be done. Now I'ma let the champagne bottle pop. I'ma take it to the top. Show, I'ma make it hot, baby. I'm down for the action, he's smart with his mouth to smack. You holding your strap, you might come back, so clap. React like a gangster, die like a gangster.
You know, everyone, like when they go to the gym, they always count like sets and reps and all that sort of shit, and which is fine, but you have to, if you look at what we've done already with this particular exercise, Joe's already done 2 sets, so that'll be number 3. Really, that's probably like your first working set, isn't it? Like the first 2 are really like a warm-up, which personally I don't count. You know, it's just a personal thing, I never count them, I count working sets. You see these guys that go into the gym and say, oh man, I did like 40, 50 sets. Okay, how many of them were actually at a decent weight where you're actually putting enough tension on that muscle? That's what you gotta ask yourself. So, you know, you're doing sets, but do you really count the ones where the weight's not heavy enough?
So same thing with this exercise as with all bicep curling exercises, you gotta focus on the eccentric, you gotta focus on the negative, you gotta focus on the unfolding of that bicep muscle just as much as the contraction. So concentric, come up, squeeze, and then control on the way down and make the most of the eccentric phase of each and every rep. It's a way big swole. That's feathers, baby.
Now we're starting to get into some money sets, man.
All right, so on that last set, I just got the 10, the 5-a-side times 2 by myself. So this now is probably gonna be my working weight, so big swole. I might need your help get some force reps.
You might get it if you're lucky.
Let's go.
All right, baby, let's do it. So you have to remember at the start, we said this is a stretch exercise. So one thing you want to make sure you're doing as well is you can see at the bottom of the rep there, Joe's bicep is completely stretched out from top to bottom. So you're not cutting the rep short doing half reps. You're actually getting that full stretch at the bottom all the way up to the top to that full contraction. So you're working the bicep at its biggest range possible. Oh, you're killing this here, man. Come on now. Yeah, come on. Come on now. That's 3. Come on, baby. You got 2 more. You got 2 more. Come on. Come on. Come on, get it. Up. It's one thing for all you guys spotting out there too, man. Make your training partner work as hard as possible. Lift as little of that weight as you possibly can and just give him a little bit of a hand up. You gotta remember, it's him training at the moment, not you. Yeah, let's get this last one now. Come on, focus. Get it, pull, up. Squeeze it. Yeah, nice. Very nice.
Oh, man.
This is where this exercise, man, it gets hard
it
real
hurts.
Quick.
So for me, man, I got like the first five, and then like two by myself with 3/4 out with Swole's help. So that's my working weight. I'm gonna repeat that for another two sets, and that'll be a wrap for this exercise. Hit the clutch, hit the gear, hit the gas, and I'm gone. Yeah. If I can't do it, homie, it can't be done. Now I'ma let the champagne bottle pop. I'ma take it to the top. Show, I'ma make it hot, baby. I'm down for the action. He's smart with his mouth to smack. Woo. You hold his strap, you might come back, so clap. Yeah. React like a gangster, die like a gangster. Fact. Cause you be hitting homicide to be asking what happened. Oh, no. Look who prepping with the foe. 20-inch rim sitting on low. Side, west side, you know, yo, I'm low, go. Even my mama saying something really wrong with my brain. Niggas don't rob me, they know I'm down and down for my chain. G-Unit, yeah. We get it poppin' in the hood, G-Unit, yeah. Motherfucker, what's good? I'm waiting on niggas to act like they don't know how to act. I had to sip it to my jack, I blow them off the map with the Mac. Thinking it's all rap, till that ass get clapped. And Doc says it's a rap, nigga. If I can't do it, homie, it can't be done. I'ma let the champagne bottle pop. I'ma take it to the top. Show, I'ma make it hot, baby. I ain't been how to teach lessons to slow learners. Go ahead and act up, get smacked in the head with the burner. I don't fight fair, I'm dirty. I'm from Southside Jamaica, Queens, nigga, you heard me. Yeah. When the street lights come on, niggas blasting eyes. Uh-huh. Get locked up, they read books to pass the time. Woo. And the game is ups and downs, so I stay on their grind. Niggas on my dick more than my bitch, I stay on their mind. There ain't nothing they can do to stop my shine. This is God's plan, homie. This ain't mine. I play the music last. Grandpa called me a nuisance. And grandma always got to throw her 2 cents. A lot of people ask us why we use lifting straps when we train biceps. You know, it's kind of, a lot of people go, well, you know, should be working your forearms when you're training biceps. What you cheating for using lifting straps? Let me tell you, man, if you're training biceps with enough intensity, with enough volume, your forearms, I guarantee you, will fail before your biceps do. And if your forearms fail before your biceps do, you're not training biceps as hard as you can. So you got to get yourself lifting straps, lifting grips, whatever it is, man, make sure you can take the bicep to absolute failure.
Yeah. And the other thing is too, man, you know, the reason I wear them at the moment is because my forearms are completely fucked. You know, you do heavy deadlifts, you do heavy rows. You know, eventually those forearms, the tendons and shit, which is what's wrong with me at the moment, the tendons are overloaded. So these give them a little bit of a break for a day.
So we've hit mid-range position of flexion. We just hit stretch position of flexion. You know what's next, Big Swole?
Oh, yeah. Are we preaching?
It's that contracted position of flexion. We're going to hit them preacher curls. So we mentioned with the last exercise, when you're trying to hit the stretch position of flexion for biceps, you want to be curling with your elbow behind your torso. The opposite is true for when you want to hit the contracted position of flexion. So whenever you want to hit contracted position of flexion, you want to be curling with your elbow in front of your torso. And the best type of movement to curl with your elbow in front of your torso is getting yourself a preacher bench. The best way to do a preacher curl is with something that's constant tension. So as opposed to using dumbbells or barbells, you want to use either a cable preacher or you want to use what we're about to use, a machine preacher curl.
I got ice in my veins, blood in my eyes, hate in my heart, love in my mind. I seen nights full of pain, days are the same. You keep the sunshine, save me the rain. I search but never find, hurt but never cry. I work and forever try, but I'm cursed, so never mind. And it's worse, but better times seem further and beyond. The top gets higher, the more that I climb. The spot gets smaller, And I get bigger, trying to get in where I fit in. No room for a nigga, but soon for a nigga.
So this exercise, we're going back to Team MassiveJoe's extended hypertrophy. 5 working sets, the same rep scheme as we did on the standing alternating dumbbell curls, exercise number 1. But because we're now fatigued, it's going to be a whole lot harder.
So remember, this is a contracted position of flexion here. So what we want to make sure we're doing is we're spending most of the time in this part of the particular movement. So you're not actually going to go all the way down like we have been with the previous exercises and stretching the bicep out. It's not a 3/4 rep, but you're going down where those biceps are still staying in tension, almost to 100% stretched, and then you're coming up and really focusing on the squeeze up here. Okay, that's what you want to do. You want to make sure you're up at that top half of the rep and you're really squeezing the bicep. So right there, you want to squeeze and hold it every single rep.
So similar mindset with preacher curls. You see a lot of people focus on the lifting of the weight and then they'll just drop it. They'll just let it drop down to the bottom and then curl it again. Preacher curls in particular really let you take advantage of the eccentric phase of every rep, so the unfolding of that bicep. So the mindset behind each and every rep, the rep tempo behind each and every rep, to be power on the way up as fast as you can, as hard as you can, squeeze as hard as you can, and then a nice controlled slow movement on the negative phase of each and every rep. All right, so a couple of tips with preacher curls, man, some hot tips. The first one is your elbows should never come off the preacher bench. As soon as your elbows come off the bench, it means you're over-contracting, which means you're bringing in your deltoids, your front delts, your rear delts, your back even a little bit to start lifting the weight. So make sure your elbows are driven into the bench and they don't come up. The second point is your wrist position. Now you can see Swole's wrists right here, man, are completely flat. He's not curling his wrists. As soon as you start curling your wrists, it's gonna take tension out of your biceps, put it into your forearms. So keep your wrists nice and flat, keep the tension in the biceps, which is exactly where you want it.
Haters believe it, I swear to God, won't spare the rod. I'm a man of my word, so your fucking head's better not. I'ma fuck around in this bitch and roast everybody. Sleep on me, that pillow is where your head'll lie. Permanently, bitch, it's Betty Bye. This world is my Easter egg, yeah, prepare to die. My head is swole, my confidence is up, the stage is my pedestal. I'm unstoppable, incredible, Hulk, you're trapped in my medicine ball. I can run circles around you so fast your fucking head'll spin, dog. I split your cabbage and your lettuce and olives. I fucking pick the world up. I'ma drop it on your fucking head. Yeah, bitch, I'ma pick the world up and I'ma drop it on your fucking head. Yeah, and I could die now, rebirth, motherfucker. Hop up in my spaceship and leave Earth, motherfucker. I'm gone, motherfucker. I'm gone, I'm gone.
It hurts, but I never show. It's pain you'll never know. If only you could see just how lonely and how cold and frostbit I've become. My back's against the wall. When push comes to shove, I just stand up and scream, fuck 'em all.
Man, it feels like these walls are closing in. This roof is caving in. But it's time to raise it then. Your days are numbered like
that. That's a really good example right there of using intensifying techniques. Usually on a rest pause, we will go for like maybe 8, maybe 9 reps. Rest it for like 5-10 seconds and then chase like another 2 or 3. Swole, how many you get right then, man? No, initially, before the first 5.
So I got 3.
No, before then.
Oh, how before many? Then? Yeah. Oh, I got 11.
11. So we would normally go to 8 or 9. Swole went to failure. The weight wasn't heavy enough, so he kept going. He got 11 reps before he failed. And then on the rest pause, usually we get 3 or 4. It wasn't heavy enough.
Five,
he went for 5. The fact of the matter is, you have to go to failure.
Yeah.
If the weight's not heavy enough or it's too heavy,
just keep going.
Just keep going. Take the muscle until it can't lift anymore.
Yep.
It hurts, but I never show. It's pain you'll never know. If only you could see just how lonely and how cold and frostbit I've become. My back's against the wall. When push comes to shove, I just stand up and scream, fuck 'em all.
Man, it feels like these walls are closing in. This roof is caving in. But it's time to raise it then. Your days are numbered like pages in my poker rhymes. Got them cooking, boy, this crooked mind of mine. Got them all shook and scared to look in my eyes. I stole that fucking clock, I took the time. And I came up from behind and pretty much snuck up and butt fucked this game up. Better be careful when you bring my name up. Fuck this fame, that ain't what I came to claim. But the game ain't gonna be the same on the day that I leave it. But I swear one way or another, I'ma make these fucking haters believe it. I swear to God, won't spare the rod. I'm a man of my word, so your fucking head's better not. I'ma fuck around in this bitch and roast everybody. Sleep on me, that pillow is where your head'll lie. Permanently, bitch, it's Betty Bye. This world is my Easter egg, yeah, prepare to die. My head is swole, my confidence is up, the stage is.
my medicine ball. I can run circles around you so fast your fucking head is spinned off. I'll split your cabbage and your lettuce and olives. I'll fucking pick the world up and I'ma drop it on your fucking head. Yeah, bitch, I'ma pick the world up and I'ma drop it on your fucking head. Yeah, and I could die now, rebirth, motherfucker. Hop up in my spaceship and leave Earth, motherfucker. I'm gone. Motherfucker, I'm gone.
It hurts, but I never show. It's pain you never know. If only you could see just how lonely.
All right, so we've hit mid-range position of flexion for biceps. We've hit stretch position of flexion for bicep. We just got done with contracted position of flexion for bicep. Pretty much the only thing left to do is hit brachialis, the part of the bicep that makes your arms look thick from front on, and hit forearms. So the way we're gonna do this is we're gonna do a superset. We're gonna superset standing, alternating dumbbell curls in a hammer curl position. So with our palms facing forward rather than facing up, and we're gonna superset that with plate curls. Let's work.
Hammer curls, man. So another exercise, you know, not a lot of people do these. I don't know why, but what we're gonna do here today is we're gonna go start with the 10 kilo plate, dumbbells, which Joe's got now, and we're gonna keep going up. Well, basically what we're gonna do is same thing. We're gonna go to failure on each set with each dumbbell. And then we're gonna go superset it with the plate curls and just get as many reps of those as you can. So, you know, like, personally, I like to try and match them, but, you know, I think today we probably won't be doing that. If we're getting 10 reps on that on the plate curls, we'll be doing pretty well. So, you know, Joe, realistically, should probably be getting about 15 reps here. We'll go up with the weights, you know, 10 to 12. But same thing, man, it's just pushing that muscle until its absolute limit each set. Got to keep in mind, this is our last exercise. We're not leaving anything in the tank now. These biceps are going to be fried by the end of this workout, so we're going to push as hard as we can. So as you can see there, you know, 10 kilos for hammer curls. Definitely not Joe's max, but you can see, hit that point of absolutely fucked. That's it, baby, that's it. Yeah, look at that. Come on, man, I said 10, that's 6. Come on, baby.
There ain't a whole lot left in these biceps, man.
Maybe I was a little bit adventurous going with 10 reps.
Yeah, shit, I would've gone lighter with the plate, to be honest. So we're aiming for 5 working supersets, so 10 sets in total when you count the 2 supersets as 2 sets. So we're just gonna keep going up, as Swole said, going up each and every set on the dumbbells, which means the reps on the dumbbells are gonna drop, and then we're trying to keep the reps consistent with the plate curls. So we're just going as many reps as possible on the plate curls, taking them biceps, forearms, brachialis, to absolute failure. Damn it, she out. Miami on fire, you better be out. Might get shot on the porch of your fortress. Yeah, they see it, but no one reports it. I run in, strip routes, spot of shit.
So as you can see, like with the technique for hammer curls is exactly the same as what you do with standing alternating curls. You can see Joe's elbow doesn't move too much. But what we're trying to do here is because we're not twisting that wrist, you're not gonna get as much of a contraction through your biceps, but it's really gonna work your brachioradialis and brachialis muscle, which runs up the side of your biceps. And also the brachialis runs over your elbow joint and into your forearm. So what we're trying to do here is really put a lot of tension into those muscles. Now people think, you know, what do you do that for? Well, putting tension into those muscles, making those muscles bigger, one's gonna make your forearm stronger, but also makes those biceps look wider, as Joe said before. So, by bringing that thumb straight up, as I said, you don't get as much contraction through your biceps, but you are getting a lot more tension through the outer parts of your biceps, through your brachialis muscle. And same thing here, man. This is almost like a reverse curl, but your hands are like on a 45. So same thing, reverse curl is really gonna work that brachialis and brachioradialis muscle. As you can see, the technique's exactly the same. You're keeping your elbows in, your elbows aren't moving, you're pulling up towards your shoulder, but you don't swing the weight. That's what you do not do.
It's such a hard superset.
This is brutal, man.
Fatiguing the brachialis and the forearms with the dumbbells, and I'm talking absolute failure, to then trying to pick up a plate. And you gotta remember, the plate doesn't have handles on it.
No.
So we're not We're not gripping it with the handles, we're gripping it with our forearms. So you're really clamping on the plate with fatigued forearms, fatigued brachialis, and trying to lift it. Man, it's tough.
This is brutal. This is a great way to finish biceps.
It's a great way to finish biceps. Let's work. And you'll notice here, we're approaching 20 working sets for biceps. We've been training for over an hour now. The biceps are absolutely fucked, but the form has not changed. The form is on point. The elbow is staying in the fixed position. The biceps, you're focusing on the contraction and then also the unfolding, the eccentric phase. That's the thing with biceps, man. As fatigued as they get, you've got to keep your form on point. You've got to keep tension in the biceps for the whole workout.
You can see with the plate too, man. It doesn't let you get that stretch. Those muscles are staying pretty much in tension.
He keeps them contracted, time. Man. Keeps them in tension. You don't get to relax at all. That's why it's so fucking hard doing this as a superset. Up, 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 up. One more in there. Come on up. Nice.
It's great that, you know, Joe started dieting out, because you can actually see, you know, that brachialis muscle right there. You can see it pop out of the side of the bicep with every rep. That's the muscle we want to work. You can see it. It's like a little golf ball under the skin. So that's the muscle we want to work. It's going to give that bicep a thicker appearance on the front.
Okay, let's come on, baby. Let's force some reps.
Let's go.
You can see me in that Boss GT, coming down sunset, sitting on D, feeling like Pac, all eyes on me, fresh bandana and I'm blowing mad trees, nigga please, I spit crack every verse of key, some say Cali, some say Cali, 12 years down and I'm finally free.
If you want to, we can supply you.
And that's a wrap. Swole?
That's how you do biceps, man.
That's one hell of a bicep.
That's how you do biceps, man.
We hit the positions of flexion, we hit the mid-range, the stretch, the contracted, we hit brachialis, we hit forearms.
Yeah, we hit everything.
Was there anything we didn't hit?
No, we hit everything.
And we're done. We did, what's that? We did 18 working sets, plus the superset. So if you wanted to count that, you're talking 23 working sets. We're done in just over an hour.
That's the way it should be done, man. Keep that intensity up, intensifying techniques. That's the way you train biceps, man. That's you want to get bigger arms, that's how you do it. So
that's it. Hey, man, we hope you guys enjoyed watching this video as much as we enjoyed making it. As always, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, man. Stay up to date with all the latest editions of In The Gym with Team MassiveJoes Live and all the other deliciousness on our YouTube channel. If you're watching on the mobile, Big Swole, you got to turn those post notifications on, man. Make sure you don't skip a beat. When it comes to the MassiveJoes YouTube channel, if you guys have any comments, questions, queries, anything for the master trainer over here, you gotta pop them as a comment down in this video, down in the YouTube comment section, man. Until next time, Big Swole, where are we coming to it from, man?
MassiveJoes.com.